Hello, we're back again, and I'm excited to talk to you about where Jesus is going in this passage about dealing with fear, worry, and anxiety. And I talked a little bit last time about how we often set ourselves up for more worry and more anxiety because we kind of believe this idea that we're supposed to be at this level. And you might liken it to the illustration that I gave back a while back about the scaffolding. Whenever we're putting all of our weight on something that we've built, it's going to be insecure. We're going to feel that life is fragile and that it's not going to be able to hold us up. And the higher we build it, the more we're going to feel fragile like that. The more we build our lives to the point where we're putting all of our weight and all of our hope into, you know, the things that we possess, the more fragile we're going to feel, the more unsafe we're going to feel. That was certainly the point that Jesus was making in the parable, the rich fool. And actually, we are more unsafe and we are more fragile because we're not building on something that is solid. And so, so really, that's what this is all about. It's about our life. And Jesus has made some arguments. I went through those arguments a few videos ago, and they're very good arguments. They're sound arguments. I don't think you can refute them. It's good logic. But I want to make the point that arguments in themselves will not defeat worry and fear and anxiety. You can't just read those arguments and say, okay, I'm going to just believe this argument and now I'm not going to be afraid anymore. This call, what Jesus is calling for, is a total reorientation of life. It's about what you seek. It's about what you set your heart on. It's about where your heart is. That's the point that he's making. And if you remember, Jesus just finished saying that, he said, "O you of little faith, do not seek what you are to eat and what you are to drink, nor be worried." Don't be obsessed about getting these things and making your life all about these things, so to the point where that's all you're seeking. It's all that you have in your sights as you look at your life and where you're heading. He says, "For all the nations of the world seek after these things, and your Father knows that you need them." And so Jesus makes that good argument. He says, "Look, don't live like an orphan. Live like someone who has a father who knows that you need them. You can leave those things to him to some degree. Yes, we work. Yes, we prepare. Yes, we plan. Yes, we save. But we don't want to be people who are characterized by that alone. We don't want to seek those things in and of themselves as the end." And so here is where Jesus now turns, and he tells us what we are to seek. This is what our life is to be about. This is where what we're to aim for. He says in verse 31, Instead of all these things, seeking what you're going to eat and drink and setting your heart on it, seek his kingdom, and these things will be added to you. So the first thing that Jesus said is here's what I want you to seek. Seek the kingdom of God. Set your heart on the kingdom of God. Now, what does that mean? The kingdom of God is the reign and the rule of God in a person's life. And so what Jesus is saying is, look, I want you to reorient your life. Don't be so obsessed and consumed with, you know, seeking things to make yourself feel secure, storing up things in barns for yourself. But rather, I want you to seek God's reign, his rule, his gracious rule in your life. So what you are to seek is to bring yourself under his, in submission to his gracious, merciful rule. To say, God is my God, God is my Father, Jesus is my Savior, and I'm going to let him rule me. I'm going to listen to what he says in his word. I'm going to let him inform my mind. I'm going to let him shape me. I'm going to let him be my king. A king is a very good illustration of what this is, because a king was a protector, a king was a provider, a king was a defender. A king was looked to by all of his subjects to be all those things. And we have a wonderful king here. We have God as a king. He's perfectly just. He's perfectly fair. He's never harsh. He's never unjust. And he's all-powerful. And so he owns everything. You know, as he said earlier here, it says, even the hairs of your head are numbered. And so he has exhaustive knowledge of all things. And he's a kind, loving father. And so he's telling us, Jesus is saying, look, don't aim for dealing with anxiety and worry Don't try to aim just for that. And don't even just use the arguments that he gives. Those are important. But the main thing you want to do here is you want to seek first the kingdom of God. And he says, the promise is, these things will be added unto you. And so we'll talk more about this next time, but that's what I want to leave you with, that reorient your heart to God's gracious, loving rule over your life. Thanks for watching.